What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Twan with the Don Light Family back at it with another video. Today I'll be doing the do's and the don'ts of becoming a sneakerhead. Let's get straight into it.
I hope you're listening. I made this song about you.
So a lot of people always come up to me, Twan, I'm trying to start my sneaker collection. I'm trying to become a sneakerhead. What should I look for? What should I not look for? So this is just a little list that I compiled to help you become the sneakerhead that you want to become. So my first do is to have a versatile collection. Having a versatile collection when you're becoming a sneakerhead is a big thing. You know, there's a lot of people that, oh, I'm a Jordan person. Oh, I'm an Adidas person. Oh, I'm a Nike person. Oh, I like Asics. I like New Balance. Oh, I like designer shoes. So I do tell people to try to have a versatile collection. Of course, you can have, you know, your favorite shoes. If that's Jordan, if that's Adidas, you'll probably have a lot more Adidas or Jordans in your collection. But I do try to tell people to try to expand what your shoe collection is. Me personally, I'm a huge Jordan guy. I definitely have the most Jordans in my collection. I probably have upwards of 20-25 pairs of Jordans in my collection, but I still try to buy other shoes other than Jordans, you know, Adidas, especially Yeezys. I like Vans, New Balances. So when I tell people, you know, what to do when they're starting their collection, be diverse, have a lot of shoes in your collection, because having a lot of shoes in your collection just shows, you know, your appreciation for other sneakers other than your favorite brand. So that's one of the things that I definitely tell people to try to do when they're becoming a sneakerhead. So my first don't is to stay away from mid-cut shoes, specifically Jordan 1 mids and Air Force 1 mids. For me, when I think of Jordan 1 mids, I think of the ugly best friend to the Jordan 1. Everyone's like, oh, I love the Jordan 1 high, I love the Jordan 1 low, and then you got the Jordan 1 mid. It's the ugly best friend of the group. So for me, when I've always looked at Jordan 1 mids, I'm like, ugh, that shoe, it just doesn't do nothing for me. The colorways are mostly trash. Like, there's not really any Jordan 1 mid colorway that looks good, in my humble opinion. You know, you have a few Jordan 1 mids that do have a cool colorway, like the blue Jordan 1 mid. And, you know, you have a few other ones that sprinkled in there. But for me personally, I just think Jordan 1 mid colorways are trash. The material isn't as good as it, you know, the Jordan 1 high or the Jordan 1 low. So I tell people to try to stay away from mids. Now, one thing with mids, the price point is really good. You know, you can get you a Jordan 1 mid for around $120, $130, you know. So that's relatively good, you know, when you're thinking like, oh, $120, $130, that's not bad. Especially when Jordan 1 highs are $170. So they're definitely in a price range for a lot of people that are becoming sneakerheads. But for me personally, it's kind of like, to each his own type of thing. For me personally, I don't like mids, and it's just kind of an unwritten rule in sneaker culture is to try to stay away from mid top shoes. So that's definitely one of my don'ts, but to each his own. You know, if you're a fan of mids, I'm not gonna, you know, be like, ah, you got on mids, you know, because like I said, there are a few mids out there that do look good, but for me personally, I just try to tell people to stay away from Jordan mids as much as they can. So my second do is to buy what you like. I cannot stress that enough. Buy what you like. You know, a lot of people want to buy the most hype shoes, the biggest collaborations, the off-whites, the stuff like that. But for me, when it comes to sneakers, I don't buy a shoe just because it's hyped up. If I don't like the shoe, I'm not going to buy it. I don't care if the shoe is reselling for $1,000, $1,500. If the shoe is trash, I'm not going to buy it. So I do try to tell people to buy what you like, whether that's a Jordan, a Nike, a New Balance, buy what you like. You know, a lot of people's like, oh, I don't like, I want to get into sneakers. You know, you got to find a brand that you like. A lot of people, you know, are big fans of Jordans and Nikes, but there's a lot of other sneakers like a Reebok, like a Puma, like a New Balance, like an Asics that are dropping really cool shoes and really dope colorways. But a lot of people really don't want to buy those shoes because they aren't as hyped as a Jordan or a Nike release is. So I do try to tell people to find what you like. Don't just cave into the hype of a shoe, but just look at the shoe and be like, yo, can I imagine myself wearing this shoe? If you can't imagine yourself wearing the shoe, don't buy it. So my second don't, and this is a big don't, please, I am begging you, don't overwear your white shoes. I repeat, do not overwear your white shoes. If you have a pair of all white Air Forces, all white Superstars, please do not wear that shoe to the point where it is a brown off-white shoe and not off-white in a good way. A lot of people tend, especially when they get a pair of all-white Air Forces, they want to wear that shoe every day. And that's fine. Especially if you're a person that's like me, you know, you like to take care of your shoes, you wash them off every time you wear them. That's fine. But if you're the type of person that just wears a shoe, takes it off, don't really upkeep their shoes, please do not overwear your white shoe. Especially with Air Force Ones. Air Force Ones cost $90. It's like $100-something after taxes. You can buy multiple pairs of those and have a rotation of those shoes. But I do not want you to wear your white shoes to the point where I'm like, is that an all-white pair of Air Forces or is that like a brown pair of Air Forces? Because some of y'all be wearing y'all white Air Forces to death. They be creased up. They be scuffed. Oh man, it's atrocious. So that's my biggest don't. Please do not overwear your white shoes. I'm begging you. The sneaker culture is begging you. Sneakerheads across the world is begging you. Please stop overwearing your white shoes. Buy another pair. Simple. So my last two do's go hand in hand with each other. The first one is buy shoes that fit your body type. And then the last do is buy shoes that fit your closet in what you like to wear. So when I say buy a shoe that fits your body type, when you look at shoes, they come in a lot of different ranges and sizes, a lot of different widths, and a lot of different heights. If you're a short person, you're not supposed to wear a shoe that is bulky. Have you seen those rappers, those small short rappers, or just people in general with those big old triple S Balenciagas? They look like clown shoes on them. It doesn't look good. You had to know what type of body type you are when buying shoes, because certain shoes matches a certain body type. If you're a bigger person, you can wear a more bulkier shoe because it looks right on you. You know, you can't be 5'5", 5'6", you wear a size 7'8", trying to wear a triple S Balenciaga because you are going to look goofy. So I do try to tell people to buy shoes that fits your body type. You know, you have a lot of shoes that's more narrow, more wide, and so you just kind of have to be and look for that. For me personally, there's a lot of shoes that kind of, you know, fits everyone body type. You have Jordan 1s that fits everyone body type. Vans work perfectly with anyone. A Jordan 4, Yeezys, especially the 350. Anybody can rock a pair of 350s. But when you start getting into your more designer shoes, those aren't made for everyone. I cannot stress that enough. You do not want to be that person in the club with your Balenciagas or your big Fendis or your big Alexander McQueen kicks, and it just look awkward. It looks like you're a clown. You look like Ronald McDonald with them big old red shoes. Like, I'm telling you, please buy a shoe that fits your body type. And then the second part is, know what's in your collection. You know, especially when it comes to your closet. Jeans are a big thing when it comes to wearing shoes. Like, if you're wearing jeans with your shoes, you have to know what type of cut jeans that you're wearing. You cannot wear dad jeans, as me and my friends like to call it, which are bootcut jeans, with a lot of these sneakers that you're buying. Bootcut jeans realistically only look good with Tim's and construction boots. You cannot wear a bootcut jean with the Jordan 1. You will look goofy. You will look like a clown. And more than likely, everyone's looking like, yo, that's a dope pair of shoes, but why would you wear those jeans with it? So I do try to tell people that when they're buying shoes, make sure you have the jeans and just like the shorts and stuff that goes with the shoe. That's a big part. Because if you have a shoe that's really dope, nice colorway, cool silhouette, but then you have a pair of jeans that doesn't complement the shoe, then the fit just kind of falls short of its true potential. So I do try to tell people, especially with like a Jordan 1 or a Jordan 4 or a Yeezy or any shoe like that, to try to buy a more slimmer fit jean. I do try to tell people to make sure you're complementing your shoes with what you're wearing. Because yes, you can have a dope shoe, but if what you're wearing is trash, then the whole outfit is trash, regardless of what's on your foot. Now, my last two don'ts go hand in hand. The first don't is, don't overpay on shoes, especially when you're starting your collection. And then the last don't is, please buy from trusted sources. I cannot stress that enough. Please buy from trusted sources, because there's a lot of fakes that's roaming the streets. So please be skeptical of and be real cautious of where you're buying your shoes from, because you can get scammed out here. And with shoes nowadays, shoes aren't cheap. So if you're paying $400 or $500 for a pair of shoes, please make sure you're buying from a trusted source. So when I say don't overpay for shoes when you're starting a collection is, you know, like I said, shoes can get really pricey. You know, shoes can resell for $500, $600, $700 if you're not able to get the shoe for retail. So what I try to tell people is, try not to overspend when you're first buying sneakers. There's a lot of reasonable shoes that you can get for relatively cheap prices. You know, you have Air Force Ones that range from about $90 to $110. You have a Nike Air Max 97 that's about $160. You have your Air Max Pluses that's about the $160, $170 price range. Then you also have other shoes like an Adidas Superstar that's about $90. You have Vans that's $60, $65. You can buy a lot of those shoes just to build up your collection, have a nice rotation, and then you can try to sprinkle in the more sought after shoes, the more, you know, the Jordan 1s, the Jordan 4s, the Yeezys, and stuff like that, that will run you about $200, $220 if you're copping for retail. So I do try to tell people to try to stay into like a nice little price range. I usually try to tell people, especially if they're starting out, to try to stay within like about the $150 to about $220 price range. You really don't want to go above that, especially if you're just starting to become a sneakerhead, because shoes can definitely get pricey. You can want to be like, oh, I want those Travis Scotts, but those Travis Scotts will run you $1,500. A lot of people don't want to spend $1,500 for one sneaker when you can probably buy you about 10, 15 pairs of other sneakers for that price of that one sneaker. So I do try to tell people to know, you know, find a price range that you're comfortable with spending when you're first starting to buy sneakers. And then the second part is, when you are buying these sneakers, make sure you're buying them from a trusted source. You know, you have a lot of sneaker sites and a lot of stores and stuff. They're really good at checking if the shoe is fake and if it's not. You know, you have a lot of trusted sources and sites like GOAT, StockX, Flight Club, and just local consignment shops, especially in the Kansas City area, like Initial, Reset, A Gallery, and just stores like that. You know, they have a known track record of selling real shoes, especially if you aren't able to cop, you know, at retail at a place like Foot Locker, Champs, Foot Action, all your local stores that you can find at the mall. So I do try to tell people to try to stay away from, you know, kind of shady pages, people selling shoes for way below what the resale value of the shoe is. Like, if you know that the shoe is reselling for $600 and the person is trying to sell you a brand new dead stock pair of shoes for $200, that's a little skeptical. So I do try to tell people to, you know, be cautious of where you're buying your shoes from. That's just like, because I don't want you to spend $500-$600 on a shoe and then come to find out it's a fake. You're going to be hot. You're going to be mad. You're going to be like, dang, I can't wear this shoe. That's just $500-$600 wasted, because most of these sites, you can't do refunds. And then you'll feel bad if you try to resell it to another person for that same price. So you can just break even knowing that you're selling a fake shoe. So I do try to tell people to be cautious of where they buy their shoes from. And just, you know, try to buy from a trusted source, a trusted site. That's like my biggest thing when buying shoes. Make sure it's a trusted, legit place. That wraps up the video, y'all. I hope these tips will help you on your journey to becoming a sneakerhead. Thank you for watching. And as always, like, comment, and subscribe. And share with your friends. Also, turn on post notifications to be notified when I drop a video. This has been Tawan with the Don Light Family, and we're out. Yeah, I ain't tryna cuff, I just wanna dig in. I just want a piece of ass, tryna make a living. All the back of all my breasts, and my breasts is just, man.